In the hills by Windermere, you'll find what for millions of people around the world is the epitome of a British garden. Heavily featured in some of the most famous children's books ever written, this garden belonged to Beatrix Potter. I'm meeting Liz Hunter-McFarlane, the House and Collections Manager. It's an iconic view, isn't it?
It is, absolutely.
You can recognise the garden from some of her books, can't you? It featured quite a lot.
That's right. The garden's almost like an extra character in some of the stories. The plants really kind of get involved, and of course there's that beautiful iconic view looking up the garden path that's at the start of the tale of Tom Kitten.
Despite its cultural significance, this garden was given over to food production during the war and then grassed over, a common occurrence with cottage gardens of the time. But Hilltops has been through its own revival, and today it's been put back to something Beatrix Potter would have recognised.
We have been left a huge selection of photographs by Rupert Potter, Beatrix's father.
Yeah.
They were taken around 1908, 1912, and they show us not just what was growing in the garden, but where it was growing and the particular varieties.
Would she have loved dabbling around amongst these plants? You just get that feeling from it.
Absolutely. We've got some wonderful letters of Beatrix's that tell us exactly what she was up to. She actually confessed that she'd stolen something from every garden in the village, just about, including some honesty.
Nicking plants, or at least taking cuttings, was a well-worn cottage garden tradition. So have you got a garden?
Yes, we have, in the Cotswolds.
And is it a cottage garden?
It is.
Do you ever steal things? Because you know that Beatrix is part
of... Oh, I never steal.
Certainly not.
Never steal.
Well, you're not a true cottage gardener then, are you?
I maybe not.
Of course, it was the stories that were set in this garden that attract over 100,000 visitors from around the world every year. Look, here's the veg garden. Can't you just imagine Peter Rabbit climbing through the gate? Look at it. They would have brought in things like these evening primroses, wonderful things which bring in pollinating insects too. If you companion plant, if you put plants together like that, you get less pests, less diseases. You certainly don't need to use chemicals. And you use every inch of space and things just grow happily together. I think gardens like this have become rarer, and yet I feel now that people yearn for this kind of reality. And you can wander around and do a bit of gardening without it being a question of keeping those edges straight and cutting that grass. I mean, no grass here, is there?